In recent years, Nifty has become a standard format for neuroimaging data. The fMRI software packages of FSL, SPM, and AFNI can all load Nifty and also generate output in Nifty format. In addition, Nifty can be read by other programs such as FreeSurfer. However, the raw data collected by the scanner isn't in Nifty format. The raw data from a Siemens scanner, for example, is in DICOM format, with a .dcm extension. When converting to Nifty format, the DICOM files are stacked together into volumes, and the volumes are concatenated together into a time series. This makes the data much more compact and easier to manipulate. To demonstrate how to use MRiCroGL's DICOM to Nifty converter, we will download a sample dataset from the Nathan Klein Institute Rockland sample. Click on the link below this video, then scroll to the bottom of the page and click on the link that says Download DICOM Files. This will take you to a new page listing the subject IDs for every participant in the study. Check the box next to Subject 247-5376 and then click Download Selected. This will take you to the NITRC page, the same website that hosts the MRiCroGL software package, and you will be required to sign up for an account and log in if you haven't already. Once you do that, the download will begin. The dataset is about 2 GB and will take a few minutes depending on the speed of your internet connection. When the dataset has been downloaded, click to unzip it. Once it is uncompressed, you should see something like this in your Finder. The subject has several different runs of imaging data: an anatomical scan, a scan during which the subject held their breath, a scan that was taken during eye calibration, and so on. There are also two folders marked Session 1 and Session 2, which contain diffusion and resting state scans. For now, let's focus on the folders ANAT and Session 1. MRiCroGL's graphical user interface makes it easy to convert all of the data in these folders by simply clicking and dragging them into the GUI. Open up MRiCroGL, and then at the top, click on Import and Convert DICOM to Nifty. You will see another window open up that looks something like this. The sidebar on the left of the converter GUI contains options you can change. The window on the right shows the output when you run the converter. The first field, Output File Name, by default contains the string FPTS, with percentage signs in front of them. Each of these letters, preceded by a percentage symbol, is called a formatting operator, which is shorthand for filling in different parts of the string. You can think of them as variables, which were discussed in the Unix tutorial. For example, if you hover your mouse over the output file name field, you will see a help bubble appear, which lists what each of the formatting operators refer to. F is the folder name, P is the protocol, and so on. These are read from the DICOM header as the files are converted into Nifty format, and if the data is not in the header, that variable is replaced with NA, for not available. You can modify these formatting operators however you want, adding or subtracting them as you wish. The string right below the field will automatically update as you change the operators. For example, the output string might read my folder, mprage, a string of numbers, _1.nai.gz. The folder name that contains the DICOM images would be the first part of the string, and mprage would indicate that the DICOMs all belong to an mprage or anatomical scan. The next part shows the date and time the scan was collected, and the last part is which scan the image belongs to. In this example, the first scan. I usually don't find that the timestamp of the file is useful, so in this example, I will remove the percentage sign T formatting operator. Note how the output file name is updated. You also have options for where to save the output files and for their format, as well as whether you want a BIDS sidecar for something like fMRI prep. The defaults work well in most cases, but you may want to change them depending on what you need. See the link to the ebook chapter below for more details. Below these drop-down menus, you can learn more about the advanced options by hovering your mouse over each of the boxes. The Crop 3D Images option, for example, can improve co-registration by removing most of the neck from the image. Once you have become familiar with the DICOM to Nifty graphical user interface, you can convert a folder of DICOM files simply by clicking and dragging the folder into the right window pane of the GUI. Alternatively, you can click on the Select Folder to Convert button and choose the directory from your Finder window. After a couple of seconds, you should see the following output in the converter window, as well as a Nifty file and JSON file in the ANAT folder. Note that some of the folders contain subfolders of other images. For example, the folder Session 1 contains a DTI folder and three resting state fMRI folders. You can convert the Session 1 folder by clicking and dragging it into the right window pane. It'll take a minute or so to convert all of the files, and when it's done, you should see the output for all of the subfolders in the Session 1 folder. Whether you want all of the converted files in that folder, or each file in its corresponding subfolder, is up to you. fMRI prep requires that the files and the JSON sidecars are located within their corresponding subfolders. You may also have to rename the files. For more details, see the link below for the Stanford BIDS tutorial. Dragging and dropping individual folders into the converter GUI might work if you have just a few subjects, but it can become tedious if you have dozens or hundreds of subjects. Once you've mastered the GUI, you can save time by running a command line version of the converter called DCM to NIIX. This is a command that comes with the MRiCrow GL package that you downloaded and is located in /applications/MRiCrow GL. You may have noticed in the output window of the converter that there is a line of text at the top generated after you've converted a DICOM folder. In the example I used to convert the Session 1 folder, it looks like this. If you are using a Macintosh operating system, click on the searchlight icon in the upper right corner of your screen, type terminal, and press enter. This opens up a command line window. Copy and paste the line from the converter window, and then replace Session 1 with ANAT to reconvert the DICOMs in the anatomical folder. It will run the same conversion as before, appending an A to the output file if a previous output file already exists in that directory. You can make it simpler to call the DICOM to NiftyX command by setting a path to it, by typing path equals $path, colon, and then the path to mricrowgl.app/contents/resources, which contains the DCM to NIIX command. Note the option -F, which contains the formatting operators that were specified in the GUI. The other options, such as -P and -Z, specify whether to use Philips precision scaling and whether to compress the output file, respectively. You can see the correspondence between the GUI and the command line by just typing the command, then pressing enter, and examining the help file. Setting the -P option to Y would be the same thing as checking the box in the graphical user interface. Also, for example, we could choose to omit the BID sidecar by including -B space N as one of the options. If you look at the output, the latest output generated, which has a B appended to it, does not have a JSON file associated with it. Once you become familiar with how to use the DICOM converter from the command line, you can use it in conjunction with for loops to automate the conversion over all the subjects in your dataset. Having covered MRiCrow GL's DICOM to Nifty converter, we will now move to its primary feature, displaying imaging data and results. We will see how to do that in the next video.